Right. So, the only take. Warhawks Entertainment Inc. presents LWL Episode 7. We're gonna give it a little bit, see if we can get it to stay. See if we can get Twitch to stop acting up, see if my internet will hold out. Hopefully it doesn't crap out on us like it did. Hopefully. I was saying, I'm trying to start LWL if the internet will hold out. If I could get my wife up here. Alright, so we're gonna try. We're gonna see if it lets me. If it lets me do it. Yes, I know it would be on time. I know I was a little late, but I was afraid of the internet crapping out on me again. So, I'm gonna get into character, everybody, and we will start this show. So, actually, we're gonna make a couple of live adjustments here. Hold on. Hold on, guys. We're gonna make a couple adjustments live since we're not sure if the internet will hold out or not. We're gonna make a couple live adjustments here. Give me a second. How's it going, everybody? We got four people in the chat. So what we're gonna do. Really? Got three tag team matches, so
Wow. Okay.
we're gonna change a couple of them to singles matches just to.
Why didn't you check this earlier today?
Huh?
Why didn't you check
I
earlier?
did.
Huh.
We're gonna do some live editing.
I can tell. I heard that.
Now, forgive us, guys. I'm typing out the current match card so I know what all matches were already here.
Yeah, because usually on average, whenever we try to change anything, it'll end up
screwing everything around. The only tag team match I'm actually keeping will be the rivalry match.
I kind of figured.
Sent it to your thing. So that way you have it.
Alright.
Hey Brent, how's it going? You haven't typed in the chat, but I know you're there. So we're going to change this to... Hold on. We're going to change this to a singles match with managers. That way it keeps the essence of a tag team match, but without the...
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
We have 6 people in the chat. How's it going, everybody? So far, nobody. Okay, would you rather have Zarios versus Mark Henry, Saito versus Mark Henry, or Zarios versus D'Lo, or Saito versus D'Lo?
Saito versus
D'Lo. Oh wait, hold on, go back. Yes. D'Lo. We have 7 people in the chat. How's it going, everybody?
Or is it the regular Mark Henry I have?
That's the one that's a member of the nation.
Yeah.
Make sure everything else is...
I love the fact that the cat is just sitting on the PS4.
I know, right?
As usual. As long as it doesn't mess with the connection, because that's what happened last time. Okay, yeah. So match number 2 is...
That one's... Those 2 are still there. Okay, that one's still there.
Yeah.
Okay, so since Theo's already a match, do you want Undertaker or Kane versus Kama? And this is just going to be a one-on-one match. Okay. Do you want any kind of stipulation before...
Table.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kane versus Kama. Should we just... Which one do you
Royal want? Royal Rumble.
Royal Rumble one?
Yeah.
Okay. Versus Kama. We'll try some Jackbox again after this. Hey, Cod. Hey, Unique Bot. How's it going, everybody? Cod, welcome back to the channel. It's been a while, man. How's it going? What? They let him out? All right. Everything else is normal.
Yep.
Okay. So, with that being said, guys, let us know in the chat what match you're looking forward to. Is it the one-on-one match with managers between Saito and D'Lo Brown? Is it the triple threat match between leading lady champion Alicia Fox, Tamina, and Cameron? Is it the match between LWL Zodiac champion The Giant and Cesaro? Is it the tag team match between Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins and Enzo and Cass? Is it the match between the tables match between Kane and Kaba Mustafa? Is it the one-on-one match between LWO General Manager Stephanie Hudson-Lytle and Stephanie McMahon? Or is it the main event Falls Count Anywhere match between Fandango and new LWL World Heavyweight Champion Will York? Alright, so we're going to start things off with our tag, with our opening match. New LWL World Tag Team Champion. Well, one half of them anyway. Saito versus D'Lo Brown. With Saito's tag team partner Zarios in his corner, and D'Lo's tag team partner Mark Henry in his corner.
I would think Zarios' like horns would have been a different color, honestly.
What color would you have preferred them to be?
One, I would have made him metallic. Mm-hmm. And probably either a black or gray.
Let's see what we can do. And we are coming to you from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania tonight.
Welcome, everybody, and thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Michael Cole.
So, if you think Saito is going to win, the guy with the pink hair, type 1. If you think D'Lo is going to win, type 2. D'Lo comes out of the gate with a back suplex followed by an elbow drop.
Look out! Are you kidding me? Look!
Oh, you can't take many more
knee
shots
to the face,
like that.
That's gotta hurt.
It's never gonna look the same.
Just slightly.
That might be a good opportunity to fill our viewers right in on D'Lo Brown.
Picks
few
him up.
People can fly through the air as gracefully as D'Lo Brown when he does low down frog splash.
Hurricane Rana.
Definitely looking confident in this 1-on-1 environment. That's a good sign.
All by rolling next step. Chicken wing.
Doing a great job of avoiding any serious offense. That'll go a long way as this one progresses.
Snap mirror by Saito. Drop kick to the back of the head.
Uh-oh. D'Lo Brown is
rolled by a hurricane run of his own.
So we kind of have a lot of Hurricane Rana considering these guys usually
makes it even more dangerous is when he wears that ridiculous and unnecessary chest protector.
What do you mean unnecessary? Now, Cole, how do you know it's unnecessary? Are you a doctor?
Picks him up. Nice chop there.
Don't expect a lot of mercy to be shown here.
Yeah, none expected and none will be shown. Look out!
Back suplex
by D'Lo.
Looks like
he's in no man's land here. He needs to be able to put things back together here.
Michael, this is a dangerous position to be in. He needs to be able to find a way to clear the cut.
Probably not, Beer Monk. I don't think so. Saito sends D'Lo out of the ring. Falls in mid out.
I'm also accepting defeat.
Glad to see you the hat for the first time tonight.
Yeah.
And into my Lego stairs.
I have a strong feeling these guys will throw caution.
So I go outside the ring in control. Snapmare followed by a knee to the back.
No, not again. Well, we're on the move here.
Oh. That strike hit the spot.
Kicks to the leg.
Could have avoided that blow.
All by a leg sweep.
and he fails to connect with anything that time.
Referee's up to five.
That was some miss, all right. I can feel the breeze all the way over here. He's too good inside the ring.
Referee up to seven, but D'Lo gets back in the ring. Saito dragging D'Lo around the ring, giving him a walk around.
Not quite sure where anyone can take him.
Snapmare into a sleeper. Easily reversed, though.
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight.
Snapmare followed by a sleeper of his own. We are up to eight people in the chat. How's it going, guys?
Brown showing signs of life once more.
If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly real fast.
All right, reversed.
Quit running your mouth and let them do this thing. T.O. Brown is making full use of this open moment.
Mark Henry using distracting again, at least for the first time in this match.
T.O. Brown hit that one.
D'Lo Brown with something to cover.
Looking for the quick
one, two, no, kick out.
Look at D'Lo Brown here.
And sends him into the corner.
And that one hit with the force of a big
weird
ring.
Move there.
You can't put a price tag on landing that perfect strike. Incredible move by D'Lo Brown.
Spinebuster into the pin combination too. No.
Showing a great deal of faith and trust in that move. You can bet every superstar on the roster is
clothesline into the corner.
And a missed drop kick of some kind.
Victorious.
That's a textbook maneuver. And that's patented Michael Cole.
I've walked slam by D'Lo.
This guy's just too strong.
Cover. One. Two.
Second time we're seeing this here.
Oh, that hurt.
Uh-oh. Oh, face first goes Saito.
No quit in them tonight.
Come on, man. You just won the tag team titles. You don't want to look like a bitch. Late DDT.
Hey, he could get a job down at the Pancake House. IHOP.
Snapmare into a sleeper.
These superstars
reversed
looking for
by Saito.
Build momentum.
You're right about
Mark Henry
so
again getting involved. Super kick.
After that, you're out like a light.
Yeah, him trying to get involved didn't quite work this time, at least.
The shoulders are down.
One, two.
Kick
nope,
out.
Kick out.
Saito.
The WWE Universe. Wearing down the opposition.
Kick
here.
In the corner there.
He's pressing all the right buttons now. Remember, momentum in WWE can turn on a dime
and leave you some change.
Oh, and he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. Give him a cold.
Human bobblehead aside, D'Lo Brown is an extremely gifted competitor and one that should not be taken lightly, particularly.
Springboard 450, shades of AJ Styles.
Top rope, get your camera ready. His brawl splash is an absolute thing of beauty.
And into a cover.
There's the cover.
One, two. No!
Nope, not quite.
Saito getting frustrated.
Hook day! Hopefully. hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues.
And again, Mark Henry distracting Saito, allowing D'Lo to hit the backstabber.
Watch it. That's it. He's
leg drop. Cover.
Hey, this may
one, two, three.
Now, if Saito doesn't win a couple of matches on his own, it might make one think maybe Zurios won the tag team on his own.
Ooh. Trying to create a bit of discord in the tag team, are you?
I'm not trying to.
Triple threat match is next. LWL leading lady champion Alicia Fox takes on Cameron and Tamina. Although why anyone feels that Tamina deserves a title match after she lost this past Sunday at Muerte de Mayo is anyone's guess.
Cameron,
so if you think that the lady champion Alicia Fox is going to win type 1, if you think Cameron's going to win type 2, if you think Tamina's going to win type 3, as Tamina hits Cameron or Alicia with a forearm, followed by a hurricane rana by Cameron.
Didn't help, Tamina just kind of missed like 4 shots before she even hit anyone.
Exactly.
A win here in this triple threat match. Solidifying yourself as a serious threat to the rest of the locker room.
I remember first seeing Tamina's father, the WWE Hall of Famer Jimmy Superfly Snuka, leap from the top with a Superfly splash. No one ever saw anything like it. Now Tamina's version of the splash is
a vote for the leading lady champion.
Athleticism and force in the entire WWE today.
And looking at Cameron, what's the story for her right now?
Looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
And Tamina has all the momentum here.
Spoken too soon, King.
Just a little. Alicia Fox.
I can't
Cameron
believe this is
now
a disqualification match. We could see anything in this one.
Could see anything. We
will
takedown. See anything. Anything and everything.
When Tamina stuck,
I'm going to be kind of curious to see if ladies even use any toys.
You see the Stuka family dynasty.
You don't see them use them very often.
Tamina's version of the Superfly Splash crushes her opponent to the point where pinning her victim is a mere formality.
Absolutely, Michael. You can hear and feel the impact of Tamina's Superfly Splash. And we have the vantage point where we can see Tamina's opponent just have the wind crushed right under their body. The impact is unbelievable.
Looking to be in great physical condition here, almost impervious to pain. Covers.
Got a cover.
They're still alive.
Looking up by Tamina.
Saw back in the day, staying alive. Well, that was it in WWE terms. Alicia Fox's agility never ceases to amaze me, Cole. She gets that big boot up so high, there's times that I think she might be able to crack Big Show in the chin.
She appears to be extra slow regaining her base.
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
Wow, what a drop kick!
Oh, we're actually getting a toy.
Back between
Mr.
the
Mr. Sledgy.
Oh, Sledgy.
And not even being picked up.
I assure you,
just brought into the ring, and that's it.
She's got her.
Jacob's gun.
Alicia Fox is
Cameron with a backbreaker
the
there.
Competitors to ever grace a
what
WWE.
The hell was
and
that?
She kind of glitched.
We've seen her hit that northern light suplex out of nowhere.
And with perfect form too, Cole. It's not easy holding that bridge as long as she does. But she pulls it off flawlessly.
Tamina with a backbreaker of her own on Alicia Fox. Where was all this fire this
Tamina,
past Sunday?
You might have been
tired. I don't
know. Leg drop.
In this match.
Yeah, I completely agree. The way things are going in there, I'd say not much longer. My gosh, this is a beating.
Sends Cameron off the ropes, back elbow.
And Alicia Fox takes advantage.
Fox looking to take advantage, but gets broken up by Tamina.
Oh, what a strike. Ooh, it's placed
and it's
kind
of strategic teaming up.
Man, that didn't last very long, though.
No, it really didn't.
Much.
Hey, JBL.
And she's missing moves.
Rick Rude style neckbreaker by Tamina.
She's putting the entire Divas roster on notice here.
Neckbreaker. Shining Wizard by the Leading Lady Champion. Now all she has to do is take her pink cover on Cameron. One, two, no.
Cameron kicks out.
Tamina didn't even give her a chance. Super kick.
Taking it to the chest here.
And a kick. Wow. Drop kick. Wow.
She didn't get all of it, but she got enough.
And Sluggy's in.
Sluggy's in.
I see you have taken Kings earlier.
Knee to the face by Alicia Fox. Cameron tried to knock her down, but got it that time.
I'm not letting Alicia
Fox
run off with another one of my hats.
Super kick again.
This one should be over after that.
Hurricane Rana.
No point in doing the command again.
Guarantee it's not a one-time occurrence. You got to be ready for anything.
Cameron with the cover. One, two, no.
A wild overhead punch wreaking havoc in here. No kidding. That shot came out of nowhere.
Tamina.
That's what happens when you're in a power.
Another backbreaker.
You go down. Oh, that slam was vicious. I have a feeling we're going to see several more demonstrations.
Pump handle slam.
It's over. That might have hurt her.
Now slamming her head against the mat.
And we got cover.
Right there. I think this is it.
There's one, but no. Broken up by Alicia Fox.
Staying alive? Well, that was it in WWE terms.
Dropkick from Alicia Fox.
And I'm sure we'll be able to see the handprint left by that chop. Uh-oh. When she gets in attack mode, look out. Look out! Look out! Oh, she wants this win bad. Putting it all on the line.
Going top row.
It should be.
Could be the Superfly Splash.
Maneuver by Alicia Fox. We've really seen one amazing move after another in this. The shoulders
are almost.
Wow, yeah, she just has to break out the cover first, though.
Oh, she does it again.
Clearly, that's what she was thinking, but.
That's called being driven straight down the canvas. What power. No kidding. That was an awesome slam. Nicely timed shot by Tamina. Alicia Fox is in position. And Alicia Fox makes her pay for all that.
There it is. The
pin.
Cover.
She kicks out.
Broken up by Cameron.
She's not just beautiful. She's tough, too. Tamina is one tough cookie. That's for sure. Yes. Cameron hit that one.
Leg drop by Cameron.
Yeah, cover.
One. Broken up by Tamina.
Talk about just in the nick of time. Oh, man. I'll tell you.
Speaking of Tamina.
That was going to be all
back by, or electric chair drop. I'm sorry.
She's having a real hard time getting back to her feet.
Alicia Fox in control currently.
Trying to make sure Tamina's going to stay down.
Once again, thank
doesn't
you for tuning
quite
in
manage
Divas
it.
Match. I would never even think of tuning out of a Divas match.
Okay.
These aren't your WWE Divas, King and Cole. These are the LWL Leading Ladies.
There are no allies in matches of this nature, but I wouldn't be surprised to see a temporary union and a little two-on-one battle taking place.
Backbreaker by Alicia Fox. Was so brutal, even the referee was cringing. Cover.
I think so. They're still alive.
Yeah, Cole, for a dirty pin, but got broken up by Tamina.
Well, that was it in WWE terms.
Speaking of Tamina, into the corner she goes. Top kick. hit was going for Tamina, but hit Cameron instead. Tamina with a double chicken wing face buster, kind of a version of a glam slam there. Cameron calling for a finisher, but gets interrupted by Tamina.
She appears to be extra slow.
Cameron with the bulldog. On next snap.
This match has been 100 mile per hour.
Knee to the face.
I don't see any slowing down in the future. This is a great matchup. I'm loving it.
Went for the super kick, but got countered into a double drop kick, followed by an assisted leg drop by Cameron and Tamina. Alicia Fox.
The match continues.
Speaking of, raking up the pin there.
That alliance didn't last very long. Again, they never do in a triple threat.
Sometimes the moves in an open
spot are on the top rope. Tree of Woe.
Damage to you as they do to your opponent. That's always something that you want to avoid, in my opinion. But then again,
Tamina prevents Cameron from capitalizing, slings her across the ring.
Now she can just, I'm about to say, if she can just stay in that Tree of Woe, Tamina has a chance.
Super kick!
You're right, this one's
as a chance. But Tamina's out here now, and
remember, no counts.
Alicia Fox is following with Sludgy.
Remember, no disqualifications or counts in a triple threat.
Domination here.
Drop kick to the leg, taking her out.
Ow, hard kick to the ribs. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen.
Rude awakening neck breaker there.
Cameron is still down.
Cameron has not moved.
With great precision.
Nice. Well, now she's moving. Now, just as we say that, another rude awakening style neck breaker by Tamina.
Somebody. We're going to see who has what it takes to win. And who might be gone for good.
And yet another rude awakening style neckbreaker.
Continue having a match under these circumstances. This
went
is
for a wind up forearm but missed.
And again, this beautiful diva decides to use that one. We're looking at complete domination here.
And another rude awakening neckbreaker on Cameron this time.
Sometimes when you get outside the ring, it's survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous...
Tamina just proving how vicious she can be. Those repeated rude awakening neck breakers there.
She's going after the
outside the ring.
Well, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen.
Say,
you got exposed steel, concrete,
I think she might be stuck in a loop there.
Used to cause massive damage.
Well, it kind of depends on if the
nice
other...
move.
Oh, out here you have to be able
or
to get on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt.
She appears to be extra slow regaining her base.
Alicia Fox with the offense.
I have to plug in my controller. Alicia Fox with a clothesline there.
Alicia Fox, who has control. She's really fixated on delivering that maneuver. That'll have you worrying about
face first.
For sure.
Ladies need to get it back in the ring.
Outside the ring, it's survival.
You can't win this match outside the ring.
Get near all these dangerous objects.
Champion's advantage goes right out the window in a triple threat match.
You're not going to win many.
And there's the submission hold. Will this do it?
Yeah, well, that's not going to do you any good outside the ring. Bell, wear down your opponent.
Would you look at this?
It will.
Can you believe it?
This now, you would think someone would head into the ring, wait for the other two to beat the crap out of each other, and when the other one tries to get in, you just capitalize on it. You would think, but
apparently not. That guy dropped. Alicia Fox sends Tamina almost into the steps. Doesn't quite manage it, though.
Playing around with my Lego steps.
Edged it that time.
A win here in this triple threat match can go a long way in solidifying yourself.
Was trying to send her into the corner, into the ring. Wound up sending her into the steps again instead.
Eventually, Eventually someone will go into the ring or the barricade. One of the two.
Eventually they'll get back in the ring.
Have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see a weakness in your opponent, you gotta jump on it.
Like right about now.
Maybe.
Yep. Well,
no, not quite.
On your feet, lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
Well.
She's
trying to get her back in the ring.
That's not quite working out.
You've got exposed steel, concrete.
And
face first into the padding on the outside there. Snap suplex.
Out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt. Here she goes.
There we go. Now we got someone in the ring.
In the ring.
I like it. Let's get this thing done inside the ring. Stay down! Stay down! Oh, what a slam! When you're being
STL by Tamina. Corner.
Behind it.
Perfect strategy. Cover. One, two, three. No!
Almost.
Almost. Side Russian leg sweep by Tamina. On Tamina by Alicia Fox. Cover. Was broken up by Cameron.
To keep this match going. Man, that was close. That was a different kind of counterattack, but hey, whatever works. Is this it?
Oh.
That's got to be it. Cameron, how about that finishing move? They're still alive.
I don't even know what Cameron calls that.
Staying alive? Well, that was it in WWE terms. This is dangerous.
Electric chair. Into a pinning combo.
Referee's count is broken.
Broken up by Alicia Fox, though.
No kidding. I'll tell you. I really
STO.
That was going to be all she wrote. Cameron is going in for the kill. That was spectacular.
Oh. Spike DDT by Cameron. Cover. One, two, three.
Gentlemen.
She didn't pin the champion, but she might as well have.
Oh, what a spot. That was one in a million. I
think Cameron might deserve a title match next week.
Certainly looks like it.
Next up is a match between LWL Zodiac champion The Giant and Cesaro. Alright, if you think the Giant is going to win, type 1.
This
you think
type of battle that you
Cesaro is going
to
win, type 2.
And say, this is what
that's how we differentiate between Big Show and Paul White. We call Paul White the Big Show. I mean, not the Big Show. Wow. We call Paul White the Giant, call Big Show Big Show.
Basically, if he has a braid... Then it's the Giant.
So give us the breakdown here for Cesaro.
Definitely looking confident in this 101 environment.
Because that's exactly, well, sort of how he looked
sure.
at WCW.
No gimmicks here. Just some good old fashioned.
His avatar is how he looked at WCW. Big boot by the Giant.
Right
now putting the boots to him.
Cesaro possesses one of the most versatile and devastating offensive arsenals
slam
I've ever seen.
He crushes opponents with his double stomp, powerbomb, suplex,
the hangman's clutch, and a brutal headbutt that could crack someone's skull.
Hyperextending that knee.
Not good at all.
It'll make it a little hard to swing there.
Just a little offense. That'll go a long way as this one progresses. Nice move.
Elbow to the back of the head there. Breaking the eyes.
Seems like these guys are letting out
Cesaro in control now.
Tonight.
Side rushing next week.
Michael, you brought up Cesaro's forms of attack, and I have to say that in more than 40 years in this business, I've never seen anything like it.
Eat to the back
Cesaro
of the head.
A suplex where he stands on the middle rope, lifts his opponents in the air from the apron, and suplexes him into the ring. It redefines the term superplex.
Elbow to the back of the head.
And
hangs him into the ropes.
Oh, it's gonna hurt.
That is 500 pounds crashing on the back of your neck, ladies and gentlemen. One, two. I'm surprised Cesaro was able to kick out of that.
One tough Swiss bulldog there.
Sat there by Cesaro. Reverse chicken wing.
Hump day. Hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues. Well, when someone is known as the Swiss Superman like Cesaro, that gives you an idea of the range of superior abilities he possesses. Cesaro's
wow.
Immeasurable power,
giant
superb
gets out
technical
of it.
Skills, and all
physical
prowess makes him almost impossible to prepare for.
And don't forget about Cesaro's relentless pursuit of greatness
in the ropes, and that may have been the only escape. We're
try
looking at complete domination
too
here.
Close to the ropes.
This is what makes him
right,
so dangerous.
By the giant, followed up to
man,
one to
man,
the midsection, kicked to the midsection,
right.
Into
that
the tree of woe.
Indeed. Good thing we're over here.
Clinching down on the neck now. King, we talked about Cesaro's incredible skill set and Cesaro's power, technical grappling acumen, and brutal strikes, which are all fueled by one thing, a vicious mean streak to dominate all of his opponents.
Top rope. That's usually not a safe place.
No love lost between these two.
Backbreaker by me, by the giant.
He can do it here.
Cover one, two, no.
Lives to fight again.
What do you have to do to keep this guy down? Gotta watch
swinging neck breaker.
Injury is not something to take lightly.
Well, Cesaro's blend of strength, strikes, and grapples are catastrophic.
Double foot stomp to the chest.
He looks to overpower and decimate his adversaries as soon as that bell
oh.
rings. Cesaro's heartless when it comes to ridding an air of the ropes.
Pinning combination, but kick out.
Well, no, it was more of a he was in the ropes.
Where did this explosion of offense come from?
Well, that messed him all right.
Big Show shoves him down.
Before firing? What an idiot.
Calling for a choke slam.
Here comes Paul White.
Choke slam.
He's out after that one. There's the
cover. Hooks the leg. That might be it. One, two.
And he escapes.
No, he kicked out.
There's no keeping this guy down tonight.
As Cesaro always happens. Never mind.
He's going back to an old friend with that one.
Yeah, you're right about that. You gotta remember.
Lifts him up and kicks him in the back.
Paul White is credited with one of the most shocking debuts in WWE history.
Hey, we're up to nine people. How's it going, everybody?
Pay-per-view broadcast team, and it was simply awesome.
It's not every day you see a 7-foot behemoth come up through the ring to launch
an attack.
Crank. The way he manhandled Stone Cold Steve Austin earned him the nickname Big Nasty.
Cover looks like forearm press. I'm sorry. One, two, no.
That is
one. Cesaro just refuses to stay down here.
Complete domination here.
Unfortunately, for Cesaro, Big Show's the giant has been in control for most of this match.
Yeah, it's hard to fight back when you've been in control. Wait. The other person has been in control for so much of the match.
And made his WrestleMania debut at the 15th show of shows against Mankind. Soon after,
kick to the face.
Known to the world
followed
as
by
the Big Show.
Knee to the back. I apparently cannot talk at the moment.
I don't think either of us can right now. Past the ring at the thousands and thousands of WWE fans in attendance. Each and every one of them are having a great time tonight.
Oh, you're right about that. You always have a great time when you attend the WWE. Hey, guys, just so you know, I do I am participating in that packed a punch. Extra this year. I'll be doing a 24-hour live stream on November 11th into November 12th. For that,
this might be it.
If you guys would like to donate,
Cesaro picking up the Giant.
Gut wrench suplex.
Triple.
If you would like to donate to that, you are not required to, but if you would like to. Cover. One, two, go. Then you can do so.
What's it take to put Paul White away?
Finish my thought by going.
Not going to win many matches with that move.
Here.
Oh no, Paul White with the opening. He's got him. Look out. Now that's how you do it.
And this has got to be it.
Yeah, with a pin.
One, two. No, even with that cocky pin, no.
Look at this. Paul White doing some good work here.
Double axe handle to the back.
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
Snapmare by the Giant. Into a rear chin lock.
Hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues. Man, this has been a great matchup.
You're right about that, Cole. Right. Matt Classic.
Let's say it was...
Not this.
Uh-oh.
Right into a choke slam. This could be it. This cover, hook slam. One,
two.
Three!
Cesaro did put up a real good fight, though.
He did, but the Giant was just too much for it.
Let's take a look back. Can't believe.
Alright, your next match will be a tag team match between the what remains of the Shield, Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins, and Enzo Amore and Colin Cassidy. World Tag Team Champions going at it here.
We're ready to go.
Wait, no, I don't think Ambrose and Rollins ever helped with tag team titles, did they?
No, but the team was for, but I don't think they ever actually won it.
Ambrose in control of Enzo right now.
It won't take long for the aggression to escalate quickly in this one.
You're right, Cole. These two don't like each other. And we're going to find out how much they really do dislike each other in this match.
In the mid-2000s, Dean Ambrose became known on the independent wrestling circuit for taking and dishing out ungodly amounts of punishment. The fans around the world, Ambrose emerged in 2012 as the eccentric leader of the Hounds of Justice, known as The Shield.
Oh, Ambrose emerged as the leader of The Shield, all right. When they arrived in WWE, the Hounds of Justice planned and carried out vicious attacks on all of WWE's most beloved heroes. Give us your thoughts about Enzo Amore.
The sky's the limit.
Amore ain't doing too good right now. Kick to the chest by Ambrose.
So much on the line in this one, like they say, on any given night.
Puffs him up.
Can happen in
step
WWE.
Up now. It's a good place.
Place you want to be.
Especially with Ambrose.
Yeah, absolutely.
You never know what that lunatic's going to do. Back superplex.
WWE's most ready both of them in the process.
Became the 77th but individual. Hurting Enzo more. Cover.
Look at catch him off.
One, two. No.
A little too soon in there.
Just a little.
Neither of the partners even tried to interrupt, so.
Elbow to the head. Now neck crank.
People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted.
Another bulldog by Ambrose.
You know, Michael, we've talked about the career of Dean Ambrose leading the
cover attempt here. One, two, no. For some reason, Seth Rollins got down there for a second. Oh, break of the eyes.
Uh-oh. Ambrose looks like he wants to finish this quickly.
Domination here.
Just a little.
He's gonna get hurt in this match.
Does he have a date?
Tagged Rollins.
Looking to go skyborne.
Rollins on the top rope.
And changed his mind.
Thought better of it.
He might have to do this by himself. His partner doesn't have much left.
Diving into his bag of
standing shooting star press. Modified Michinoku driver cover. One, two. No, kick out.
Seth Rollins leads a quiet life away from
now. Seth Rollins
sends Dean Ambrose sends Colin Cassidy outside the ring
to see his first WWE show at the Wharton Fieldhouse.
Sends Enzo into the corner,
and that's when it all began.
Flying forearm,
doing whatever it takes to win.
Can you blame him?
Rollins going to the top rope again.
Whoa!
Frog splash. Eddie!
All the damage he's taken.
And
he got it, but he hurt himself.
Himself
as
in
well.
The process, yeah. Was it really worth it?
According to him, it was.
I don't know. Kind of.
Airplane spin by Enzo.
Steam ahead.
I hope you're right. That's exactly what I want to see. Michael, Seth wanted to follow his dream to WWE, literally. Seth traveled to Phoenix, Arizona, so he could see WrestleMania 26 live.
Colin Cassidy, finally, for the first time in this match.
It's no surprise that Seth Rollins is one of the premier superstars in WWE today.
Sends him off the ropes. Jack body drop. This drop.
I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Me too. I've given up even trying
now
to figure
right
out what
they're going to do.
Right hand
by Colin Cassidy, followed by a knee to the head.
It's an amazing atmosphere in this arena tonight.
Well, you're right. Big fight feel here, no doubt.
It's no secret Seth Rollins grew up with a dream of being a WWE superstar. Very few people know that Rollins was actually in the crowd at WrestleMania 26. No one knew
Dr.
just 3 years
Tyler,
later.
I think is how you say your name.
No kidding. That's got
I apologize if I'm like completely butchering it. This only a two count. I apologize if I'm completely butchering your name, but welcome to the channel.
Seth Rollins is showing his brilliance in there right now.
Into the turnbuckle.
In the end zone, Cassius. Corner tag to Enzo might not be the smartest move. Splash by Enzo. A little help from Cass. Easily broken up by Ambrose.
That shoulder's being torn apart. This is a ruthless attack.
Have you ever had your shoulder torn apart, Cole?
No.
We all know the amazing array of moves Seth Rollins has at his disposal to decimate an opponent. What does that tell you about his finish?
Enzo has Rollins in the corner.
Alley-oop. To the mat.
Going to the top.
Enzo going to the top rope. Might not be the best idea.
Oh, he whipped that
and
one.
Told you. Not a problem, sir. How you doing?
And there's the tag. And the
that is painful as hell.
What would you call that?
Effective.
There's a lot of effective things, you know? I think it needs its actual name, but...
Sickening thud as his body is driven to the mat.
Nothing I can think of wouldn't be too...
Shoe shopping?
Corny. There you go. Shoe shopping. Dream Street after that one. That'll work.
If we see it again, it's close shoe shopping, I guess. I don't know. You know, that would work more for the ladies than it would the guys, but meh.
You don't think so. Back into the corner goes Rollins. Now into the ring post. A lot of pride on the line
here in this tag team encounter. Well, their partners just kind of battle it out outside.
Well, they can't break up the pin if they're outside.
Yeah, true.
They also can't be tagged.
Nope.
Elbow to the knee, and I don't think Ambrose is up at the moment.
Not at all. Walk away with the win. As far as we can tell. Oh, he's just having fun over there. You saw him for a moment. Got to cover.
One, two, three. I will be damned.
Ambrose tried to get in. Didn't quite work.
Didn't quite make it.
Look who's come out here, Michael.
Oh, hi.
I think that might have been the East River Crossing.
Huh.
Might have been. Don't quote me on that. Alright, your next match is a tables match between Kama Mustafa and Kane. Speaking of Kane, who just came out.
So you would think he wouldn't have to enter again, but lo and behold, he's got to enter again.
Alright, so if you think Kane is going to win this match, type 1. If you think Kama Mustafa is going to win, type 2.
We currently have one table already set up for them, which could honestly make this a very short match.
Table matches are usually pretty short.
That may not happen for a couple of days.
Leg drop by Kane.
Tell us your views on the big red monster.
The female voice you hear if you're new to the channel is my wife.
The one pride and true finisher he prefers more than any other is that nasty
spinning sidewalk slam.
Here's somebody who's willing to do just about anything to get to the top. I like it. That's the way it should
be. Yes, that's right, ladies. Sadly, I am married.
Doesn't know if he wants to stay in the ring or not.
Clearly
and
not.
Got rid of the chair for a what second. Kind of.
Second. I've been looking forward but to this. Again, notice qualifications. They can use it. It's as legal as a headlock.
All right, standing the knee.
Ouch, that is painful. Absolutely no keep the big man tonight. Off his feet.
In addition to the sidewalk slam, we've seen Kama
rolled onto the chair.
To put opponents away.
Yeah, like I said, Cole, Kama can beat you.
Oh, apparently, by the way, in my Iron Man match, this past Sunday with Dean Ambrose, I gave him a minor injury.
Oh, whoops.
Yeah, he's cleared to wrestle.
Clearly, considering he just wrestled,
but
yeah, that's exactly
I injured him.
Witnessing. A butt whooping.
Just be thankful I didn't injure him worse.
I think you just had too much fun in that, honestly.
Just a little. Yes, guys, I am the SmackDown General Manager, but my nickname is the Iron Man, and Dean Ambrose tried to do gimmick infringement, so I had to teach him a lesson.
See it working right here. You know, for a militant thug,
come
I
here,
hear
kid.
Kama Mustafa has a bit of a way with the ladies. Oh, dear.
You come here. Ah, damn it. Ah, son of a...
Hey, Case?
Sorry, guys.
The big red monster seems to have a sadistic grin right now. Outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance in there, but only one can walk out victorious. Who will it be?
Currently, Kane has brought the chair in the ring. I mean, the table in the ring. Kama has the chair.
You have to think that's it.
Scoop slam by Kama.
I heard the same thing you did about Kama Mustafa. It's odd. I wouldn't expect a guy with such a no-nonsense tough exterior.
Now Kama sets the table up in the corner.
Just because a guy walks around with a constant scowl on his face and finds joy.
Oh, sidekick by Kama.
Wow. He's still down after that.
Kama Mustafa currently in control.
If he suffers much more, he may lose all mobility in that shoulder.
Yeah, that shoulder could become completely dislocated.
Snapmare by Kane taking control.
From our vantage point, it doesn't even look like a sweat has been broken.
Of Farouk and The Rock, and he becomes even more dangerous.
Gutbuster,
man. He's all business.
And that's the way he has to be if he wants to win here tonight.
Uh-oh. Kama going for something here.
Oh, looking to make a statement here. It's all over but the shouting.
There it is. The finisher.
But
this could all be over right now.
He is just getting busted up. Boy, he just got laid out.
What a match. Momentum. You're right, John. When you pair Kama Mustafa up with the rest of the Nation of Domination, it becomes incredibly dangerous. Just ask DX. It was Kama, Owen Hart, and D'Lo Brown who beat them on a pay-per-view in May 1998.
If his back wasn't hurt before, it certainly is now.
Yeah, that's going to be hurting for a while.
Break the eyes again.
Kama Mustafa takes the upper hand here.
Backbreaker.
Why has he got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Another backbreaker.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in.
He's in big trouble.
Powerbomb.
This guy's just getting worn out.
Kama grabs the table.
Yeah, and you can also ask the Legion of Doom how dangerous the Nation of Domination can be. Hawk and Animal had no chance at Bad Blood 1997 when they went up against Kama.
And Kama wins.
And he's got to feel great. That match was incredible.
All right, our next match is a rivalry match between Stephanie Hudson-Lytle, the LWL general manager, and Stephanie McMahon. So if you think Stephanie Hudson-Lytle, the LWO general manager, is going to win type 1, if you think Stephanie McMahon is going to win type 2.
She's got her sights set on damaging that arm.
General manager currently in control.
That is exactly what she needs to do to solidify herself as one of WWE's top divas.
Hudson is an interesting subject, to say the least.
Well, I don't think it's a shock to see her doing so well. By
the general manager.
She's going to have to stay sharp.
To avoid confusion, that's what I'm going to refer to her as.
The divas division is fierce right now.
Scoop power slam.
She's not net taking any prisoners in this one.
Back,
she's
on a mission here. To the back here. Of the net. Covered by the general manager. Covered. One.
And she raises her shoulder to interrupt the referee's
count.
She sure did.
Wow. Stephanie just barely got that shoulder up.
Elbows to the head.
And his heartless attack continues.
Oh, man. This is getting tough to watch. There doesn't seem to be any slowing her down now. We know what this is.
And a choke slam.
Hudson scores big.
Man, that was an absolutely
cover.
Unbelievable move by Hudson.
One, two, no. Stephanie McMahon kicks out.
I don't recall the last time I've seen these divas look more focused than they do here tonight.
This match may end right here.
And the general manager going for a super drop kick.
There's the apron drop kick. That'll do it.
That was vicious.
Don't think she's getting up from that. Cover. One, two. No, she kicks out.
Saving. This match goes on. I can't believe Stephanie McMahon has more fight in her.
Wow, that overhand punch started down behind his feet and just kept coming.
Man, that came out of left field.
They're into the corner. Out with the right hand.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see a weakness in your opponent, you got to jump on it. Look out.
Back suplex.
The back of the head.
Cover.
She's got the cover.
One. No, Stephanie McMahon grabs the ropes. The referee actually sees it. And yet isn't breaking up the count. What the hell?
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with
really?
Us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
Really? Really? Baby.
Yes?
Come here and look at this.
This match is living proof that the divas of the WWE are so much more than just a pretty smile.
The game glitched.
Uh-oh.
Here, if you missed any of the matches for this week.
Interesting.
To catch up on.
Yeah, because the rope. She grabbed the rope.
Yeah, but usually that means the fucking...
This has actually happened before. When someone grabbed the rope and then it was just stuck. I think it was during my match too, actually. Why is it my matches? If someone grabs the rope, it glitches. I don't get it.
I don't know, but that's fucking bullshit.
The winner of this one will be making a statement that everyone will hear.
The competition in the Divas division right now is the hottest I've seen in a very long time. Share with us your thoughts on Stephanie.
Of course,
McMahon.
I restart the match and Stephanie McMahon automatically takes control.
And once again, we see a return to this specific maneuver. Hey, whatever works.
Yeah, it keeps working. Keep working.
Kill me. Apparently, Stephanie McMahon does not like losing.
No, I think what it is she told the ref if that if she has to grab the rope to just glitch the game so I can just restart it. Clearly, that's what she did.
Because you were in control, and then...
Dude, I was winning. What are you talking about?
You were winning. You had the match won. She grabbed the rope. And it glitched, so you had to restart the match. So now she's...
She had a fresh start.
Which is bullshit. She done hit her with a choke slam and a super drop kick before.
Look at these two giving it their all.
You know, super drop kick, what Roman Reigns does.
We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance
Stephanie
in there.
Stephanie Hudson Lytle into the tree of woe. Victorious.
Who will it be? There it is, the single leg camel clutch.
Single leg camel clutch.
Camels are all over the country. And another one.
I like this. It's called repetitive, Cole. It works.
Snap there. Going next snap.
A lot of chatter on social media over this Divas match here tonight. Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE. Again, man, what a way to bring an opponent down.
You're right, that was some slam. Even if you can get back to your feet after a move like that, at this stage of the match, you're still struggling to find your balance. Ow. Look out, what's going on here?
She's targeting the
arm breaker by Stephanie Hudson Lytle.
Here.
All these power moves tonight are making bigger and bigger impacts. This may settle the score right
choke
here.
Slam by the general manager.
That big. Man, that was an absolutely unbelievable move by Hudson.
One, two, no.
Man, she's not just beautiful, she's tough too. Whoa, Princess McMahon was very close to getting put away there, Cole. Look at this. This could be it. Man, this
spine buster by Stephanie McMahon.
This type of power.
No,
she might be choking. Hey, the shoulders are down. And a kick out. No. It looks like there's some more fight left in this diva. That's one way to make your lunch come back up.
Stephanie's taking some pressure here and is in bad shape. She must turn the tables before this match is over and it's too late.
Oh. You really think she'd stop by a stream just to get taken down? Tombstone!
This one's in the books.
Yeah, you don't get
cover.
Up those.
One, two.
And she raises
no.
her to interrupt the referee's count.
She sure did.
Kicks up.
I can't believe Stephanie McMahon has more fight in her.
Really, the person is that big. The character of Stephanie McMahon.
What a brutal way to take someone off their feet. You got to be kidding me.
Yeah, that was quite the slam, wasn't it, Cole? Oh, man. How do you stand after an attack like this?
I wouldn't be surprised if all feeling from that arm was lost.
And that shot was dialed in. The crab is cinched in. The knee is torqued, putting the back in a lot of trouble. Great hold being applied. Wait a minute. Yeah. She escapes the hold.
With a move like that, she's just trying to insult her opponent.
Watch out here.
Sends the general manager out of the ring onto the apron. Oh, looks like she's going for...
Oh, no way.
Yes, DDT on the apron.
Man, that'll give you a splitting headache. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricade.
I'm running to see from being dizzy. I don't think I see JBL's hat.
Rolling next snap.
Somebody say Deja Vu. Once again, this team is utilizing one of her favorite moves.
Yeah, we've seen that before, and I have a feeling we're going to see it some more. Oh, great move. Oh, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt. Very nicely done.
Cutting off the circulation of that leg. Referee up to six. The general manager isn't moving.
You used to love being outside the ring.
Playing my games.
Yeah, a little intimidation there. Back into the ring now.
Hudson Lytle getting back in the ring just in time.
Man, she's making it
getting
easy here.
Getting right back out. Come down to the wire here.
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
I think you need to go flying.
Just a little. Back superplex by the general manager. That has gotta hurt.
Did you enjoy that flight?
Enjoy your flight. Cover. Maybe. Looks like dirty pin. One, two, three. No.
Really?
Went for the choke slam, but gets countered into a pedigree.
Wow, that was brutal. Oh man. Here's the
cover. One, two, three. She just barely managed to beat you. Just barely.
Besides the fact she's only beaten me, what, once now? Maybe twice? I'm not too hurt about it.
She pointed at you almost to say, the authority always wins. Like, bitch, please. Not that Stephanie McMahon is a bitch. Stephanie McMahon, the person, is actually a nice person.
And now for the final...
For the main event of the evening, a Falls Count Anywhere match between Fandango and the new LWL World Heavyweight Champion, the Sickness, Will York. Alright, so if you think that Fandango is going to win Type 1, if you think the Sickness Will York is going
to
win Type 2.
These superstars have to sign a contract to compete in a match. They know what they're getting themselves into.
The excitement in the air is palpable for this no-holds-barred contest.
Yeah, and that's because they know these competitors have free reign to do whatever they need to pick up the win. I'm not sure if we've ever seen a superstar more graceful jumping from the top rope than Fandango. But when he lands his leg drop across his opponent's throat, it's not the shoulder.
And the shoulder's up.
And the match continues.
Not even a one on the world champion.
Some very opportunistic offense here.
I'm not sure I can watch this. Oh, what a chop.
Even more damage to the chest.
Oh, that Fandango
in control at the moment.
And there's the schoolboy covers.
Schoolboy. Cover.
The
shoulders
are down. Here's the cover.
I would have been disappointed in Will if that had been three. I would have been so disappointed.
And also,
I'm also highlighting that moment where the freaking game glitched. This always happens.
Now it's in my matches, if anything else.
All right. Fandango sends the champion to the outside, but that is not going to help him.
I'm not sure I can watch this.
He's chopping, but he's getting the referee as well.
Textbook offense here.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. The show
cover one. Oh, not even a one count.
Adding insult
to the head.
I'm not sure I can watch this. Fandango's fancy footwork doesn't just make him an elite ballroom dancer. He's smooth in the ring with a mean streak a mile long. Fandango's training has given him an amazing level of agility, balance, and control that can see him fly off the top rope and rub his opponent's face in the mat.
Crashing to the canvas like that can tear muscles and break bones.
No kidding, this may be close to being over. Man, he's still down after that move.
Apparently our world champion has had enough. Picking up the steps.
Using the steps as a weapon.
This just gets worse.
And again off the head.
Those steps do not feel good, ladies and gentlemen. I can tell you from experience.
He's making a statement here with this attack. Fandango brings his unmatched precision and grace with him to the squared circle. His abilities enable him to anticipate what's going to happen in the ring and quickly.
The shoulders are
cover. One. Two.
And he breaks the
count,
forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done.
If anyone in WWE.
Schoolboy. One. Two. No.
Makes the cover. I can't believe this is a no disqualification.
Renagi!
Now that's how you make a statement.
The shoulders are down.
Plenty of fight left.
You're right. This guy's still near 100%. Wow. Well, you may not care for his dance moves, but he's more than just style. I mean, what else do you have to hit Fandango with to defeat him?
Ring post. Back into the ring.
Doing a great job of avoiding any serious offense. That'll go a long way as this one progresses.
Cover.
The shoulders are down.
One.
And it's up.
Not even a two count.
Going for it again.
Man of the corner. Tornado DDT.
Hump day. Hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek moves.
First DDT, how that busted him open when he fell back first, I don't know, but
just look at this. Oh no!
I don't want to know what that feels like.
Yeah, well, I've felt it.
Elbow drop by Fandango.
You don't want to know.
Fandango looking to attack from high.
Boy, there's no way he's going to be able to stand after that.
Watch out! Get out!
Went for his leg drop and got caught into a choke slam.
Yeah, but now can Wyatt capitalize?
Cover.
The cover.
One, two, no.
What will it take to put this man away? Just what will it take?
Again, these superstars are bound to absolutely no rules here in this disqualification.
And Fandango makes him pay for all that.
Cover.
Hey, the shoulders are down.
One, two.
And a kick out.
No.
And the kick out's all that's saving. This match goes on. No, not again. Well, we're on the move here.
Kick to the back of the head.
You know, if he keeps that up, he might jam his finger. Oh, a serious knockout blow.
Talk about a target. The largest bullseye is always in someone's back.
Yeah, that's bad. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
Cover.
The shoulders are down.
And he kicks out.
And he lives to fight again.
Really?
Keep in mind, this is no disqualifications. Anything can happen in this one.
That's right, and that's what we're expecting. I love the unexpected. Anything can happen, it probably will.
One, two,
and no.
What do you have to do to keep this guy down?
He's in full-on attack mode now. Well, out here, you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, that's it. He's done.
You can see him struggling to stand.
Cover. One, two, no.
He managed to get a shoulder up.
But like they say, Cole, timing is everything.
There's no keeping this guy down tonight.
Sickness back in control.
It's all okay in this one. A no disqualification.
You're right about that, Cole. That means anything and everything goes. Throw the rule book out the window. There may be no fighting out of this.
Could this be? Yes, the down with the sickness. We have seen it. Cover. One, two. No.
Wow. Well, you may not care for his dance moves, but he's more than just style. I mean, what else do you have to hit Fandango with to defeat him?
How's that for a song? Now you have to stay on top of your opponent so your weapons tactic doesn't backfire. We all know what they say about car.
Grabbing my Lego stairs.
He's like, don't worry, step up on that.
Usually when someone decides to
that's
use
not
a weapon,
back.
You can almost gear. This might be it.
He's like, I didn't play win.
Forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. What will it take to put this man away? Just what will it take? He's got him hooked. When you look at the career of Fandango, you have to look at when and where he made his in-ring debut here in WWE.
Trying to call for it.
WrestleMania 29. What's even more impressive?
The Dirty Deeds.
The top driver, a.k.a. Dirty Deeds.
Right about that, Cole.
Cover. Here's the leg. One, two.
Oh, look at that.
No.
Get a shoulder up.
Well, like they say,
I thought that was it, but I guess not.
What do you have to do to keep this guy down? He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
I can't blame him.
Get and taking ring. Out the ref in the process. Now, guys, come on. Me. All four. Nope,
changed
his mind.
Guess
when
not. Swinging neck breaker.
Hey, step there. Statement.
Into a rear chin lock.
Reverse.
Jawbreaker.
I don't know if these guys expected this type of punishment when they signed up for this no disqualification match.
Well, I knew it was going to be grueling.
It's but in the corner.
It was going to be this grueling.
Well, so I was going to take out my ref again.
In that case, it would have been the ref's fault.
Do you see this assault? It's like a street mugging unfolding right in front of us.
No kidding. This is hard to watch.
Cover.
He may get the three count right there.
One, two, no.
Well, as long as it's up before that three count, that's all that matters. I can't believe it. He just won't go away. Look at this.
You're a Nagi.
All these power moves tonight are making big.
Cover. One, two, three. It is over.
Your winner, ladies and gentlemen.
And the sickness has won.
Buddies and all.
Let's take a look back at.
All right. Guys, so we actually managed to get through LWL without any problems.
Well, one glitch.
But I mean internet wise.
Or Twitch wise, whichever.
Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna take a look at the match card for SmackDown.
Potentially could be changed.
Could be changed, I'll let you guys know. And then we are going to sign off for the night. So, let's do that right now. Alright, our opening match will be WWE Champion Shawn Michaels taking on Mankind. Natalya taking on Paige. Eric Rowan versus Titus O'Neil will follow that up. After that, it will be WWE Tag Team Champions Edge and Christian taking on the Usos. Followed up by WWE Divas Champion Nightingale taking on Summer Rae. Then it will be Ultimate Warrior taking on Chris Jericho, taking on Daniel Bryan to see who will take on United States Champion Kevin Owens this Sunday at Judgment Day for the United States Championship in our co-main event of the evening. And then finally in our main event of the evening it will be, speaking of United States Champion Kevin Owens, after showing up on Raw for no explained reason, he will be taking on Dark Raven.
Remember, the Juggernaut did say he was probably going to invade SmackDown for the fact that he just showed up.
Exactly. Uninvited, I might add. I did not send him.
You sure?
I'm positive. I would not. If I was going to send anybody to invade Roger, it wouldn't be that badass.
I want to double check my brand.
I did. Yeah. All right. So, that being said, we will see you guys Friday for SmackDown. Nightingale and the rest of them will be here. We love you guys. Steph, you want to say anything?
Well, let's see. If the others were here, they would either say, get the hell out, or get out, meow.
Get
or
out, meow. Get your shit and get out.
Others various catchphrases. You know, I'll come up with one. Probably in a couple days. We'll figure it out.
We are the Warhawks. You are the Warhawks Army. I'm the Iron Man. You are not. We will see you guys later.